Krishna was born at midnight. His parents, Vasudeva and Devaki, were locked up in prison. Outside, it was raining heavily. The Yamuna river that was close by was flooded. Waiting for the arrival of their eighth child, Devaki and Vasudeva were praying to Lord Vishnu. Devaki's brother Kamsa, Lord of Mathura, was waiting in his room. He called the jailer and issued a strict order.
I must be informed the moment the child is born. I'll kill it with my own hands.
Just a few years ago, Kamsa was a devoted brother to Devaki. They were cousins and were very close to each other. On the day of her wedding, he took the newly married couple in his own chariot, in a procession. As everyone rejoiced, a voice was heard, loud and clear. The eighth child of Devaki will be the destroyer of all evil in this world. Kamsa was filled with fear for his life. Fear turned into hatred. Hatred turned into anger. He jumped off the chariot, drew out his sword, and charged at Devaki. Vasudeva stopped Kamsa. "Devaki has done you no harm, Kamsa," he said in a quiet voice.
"Her son is going to kill me."
"But you cannot harm your own sister."
"All right, she will live. But all her babies shall die as soon as they are born,"
said Kamsa. Devaki and Vasudeva were not allowed to leave their house. Kamsa threw his old father into prison and he was now the Lord of Mathura. Kamsa put to death every child born to Devaki. The seventh baby was stillborn.
"I'll wait for the eighth child,"
said Kamsa. He moved the couple to a well-guarded prison. Soon, Devaki delivered her eighth child. Lord Vishnu appeared to the couple. "I have taken birth as your eighth child. Your seventh son too is still alive, Vasudeva. He was shifted using magic to your first wife, Rohini's house." Lord Vishnu blessed the couple and vanished. Vasudeva's first wife, Rohini, lived in the village of Gokula on the other side of the river Yamuna.
"Devaki, our seventh child is alive and Rohini is looking after him. Our eighth child too is safe. It is Lord Vishnu himself," said Vasudeva.
Devaki looked at her little son. He was dark and handsome. He had a bewitching smile.
"Krishna, my Krishna,"
she whispered as she kissed the baby.
Krishna means the one as handsome as the rain-bearing cloud.
To his surprise, Vasudeva found that the chain binding his legs had come off. The prison gates too opened magically. The guards had fallen off to a deep sleep. Vasudeva tenderly picked up baby Krishna, hugged him and placed him in a basket. "I'll take you to safety," he said softly. Devaki watched, her heart beating fast, prayer on her lips. Vasudeva walked out of the prison
carrying baby Krishna in the basket, uttering the name of the Lord, Govinda, Govinda, Govinda.